Next, we will have a look how the cardinality constraints in entity relationship diagrams are translated into the relational model. We will see that we will make use of eliminating tables and integrity constraints to model the cardinalities as good as possible. First of all, when translating entity sets and relationship sets into the relational model, so into tables, every table should have a primary key. And for every relation, we should declare the corresponding foreign key constraints. For the foreign keys, we should additionally think about whether these keys can be declared as not null or unique. And the idea here is that we want to use these constraints, not null and unique, in order to model the cardinality limits as closely as possible. For instance, if you have a table obtained from the translation of a relationship set, then all the columns in this table are foreign keys, and they can never be null. So then we can declare all the columns as not null. Beyond the foreign keys, we also need to consider the attributes. Also, for the attributes of the relationship sets and the entity sets, we have to think about whether they can be declared as not null or unique. We should declare attributes as not null if we do not want that the user can fill empty values, can leave the cells empty. And we should declare them as unique if we are sure that this attribute uniquely identifies the entity. And indeed, we can have situations where we have primary keys that uniquely identify the entity, but we also have other attributes, secondary keys, that identify the entity as well, and declaring them as unique helps to prevent input errors. Now let's have a look how the cardinality constraints can be translated from the entity relationship diagrams into the relational model. So our goal here is to enforce these cardinality constraints by the design of the database schema. First, we have a many-to-many relation. Every A is related to an arbitrary number of Bs. Every B is related to an arbitrary number of As. And clearly this can be modeled in our database schema. This is our basic translation of a relationship set into a separate table. The separate table can contain arbitrary connections between A and B. Next, we would like to model a 0 or 1 to many relation. Now every B is related to 0 or 1 A's. So how can we enforce this cardinality in our database schema? The idea is to extend the table of B with the key of A. So we include in the table of B a foreign key that references the table A. Then every column in the table B, so every entity of B, has a reference to an entity of A. So if this reference is null, then this entity of B refers to zero entities of A. If this reference has a value, then the entity of B refers to one entity of A. And by including the key of A in the table of B, we maintain that every A can be related to an arbitrary amount of Bs. We can point an arbitrary amount of Bs to the same entity A. Next, we want to enforce a precisely one-to-many relation. So now every B is related to precisely one A. And in principle, the idea is the same. We include the foreign key, we could include the foreign key in the table of B, and this foreign key references the table A. But what's the difference between 0 of 1 or precisely 1? At the moment, we didn't mention any difference. The point is, we want to exclude the case of zero referenced entities. So we want to exclude the case that this foreign key can be null. So we have to declare this foreign key as not null. Then we are sure that every entity B refers to precisely one entity A. Next, we want to model a 0 of 1 to 0 of 1 relation. Now, we can do the same. We can include the key of A in the table of B. Since this is symmetric, we could also do it the other way around. We could include the key of B in the table of A. But let's say we do it as before. We include the key of A in the table of B. Now, this gives us a 0 of 1 to many relation. But now we want a 0 of 1 to 0 of 1. So the question is, what additional constraints do we need to enforce such that this many part here becomes 0 1? The idea is that we have to declare this foreign key as unique. So if every entity B refers to a unique A, reversely, this means that every A is referenced by at most one B. And this gives us precisely the cardinality 0 or 1 to 0 or 1. Next, we want to model the cardinality 0 or 1 to precisely 1. And as we have done before, the idea of going from 0 or 1 to precisely 1 is declaring this foreign key as not null. The only difference is that now the precisely 1 is on the other side. So in order to model this, we have to include the key of B in the table of A. So we include the key of B as a foreign key in the table of A, and we declare this key as not null to achieve the precisely 1, and we declare this key as unique to achieve the 0 of 1 like we did in the last step. If we want to model a precisely 1 to precisely 1 relation, then we simply can join the two tables. So if every A belongs to precisely 1B, then we can just put the two tables together and we can put the entities that belong together in the same row. Finally, let us mention that there is no nice translation of at least one. So if you want to ensure that every A is related to at least 1B, then this means that we have to include the key of B in the table of A. But then if we include the key of B in the table of A, we cannot model the possibility of having more than one B that the A's are related to. So we would need some kind of hack, some additional table, but then we store the information about this relation in different places, so there's no nice way. So in order to keep the translation elegant, the workaround is to approximate this cardinality at least 1 by at least 0, so by an arbitrary amount. And then we can use one of the cases that we've discussed above.